morning, everyone. I'm pleased to have the opportunity to stand here today with Representative Combs, Ms. Martin, and Dr. Bechtel to speak with you today about the dangers of skin cancer in House Bill 173. House Bill 173 is a very important piece of legislation that is not a Republican issue nor a Democrat issue, but an Ohio health issue, and I am proud to be working with Representative Combs to get this bill passed. Furthermore, it is only fitting that we have introduced this bill now, as May is Melanoma, or Skin Cancer Detection and Prevention Month here in Ohio. This bill will go a long way to help accomplish those goals. It is almost impossible to find someone that has not had their life touched in some way by cancer, whether it involves a personal physical struggle against the disease or standing shoulder to shoulder with a loved one who has been diagnosed. Skin cancer, melanoma, is one of the most common forms of cancer and is often the most lethal for young people. House Bill 173 seeks to address this threat to Ohio's youth by regulating the use of tanning beds for individuals under the age of 18 unless they have a doctor's consent. Quite simply, the perceived cosmetic gains associated with tanning beds are not worth the irreparable damage resulting from the intense UV radiation the beds produce. While opponents of this legislation will state that it is unnecessary, the health concerns are real and very immediate. Previously, we have banned the sale of cigarettes to individuals under 18 because of health concerns. Is this really any different? And in my opinion, it is not. Skin cancer is deadly, and it can show up years after the exposure to UV rays. This bill can help save some of those lives at the expense of only a teenager's vanity. And before I introduce Representative Combs, I just wanted to tell you a little bit about my experience. 4 years ago, I had a spot on the side of my nose that wouldn't heal, and I went to a doctor and had it removed because it was precancerous. Most recently, about 5-6 weeks ago, I went to my dermatologist's office, who, while I was there, asked me why this bill didn't pass last session, and then ensued a considerable conversation regarding skin cancer. But I was in my dermatologist's office because, again, this time I had a growth that would not heal on my leg, and it's still in the process of going through that healing process. But because of that, and my dermatologist's inquiry about it is really what prompted me to sign on and to help get this bill passed into law. So with that, I would like to turn over the microphone to Representative Courtney Combs.
Thank you, Representative Fende. I want to personally thank Representative Fende for coming on board with this bill. It shows bipartisanship and that we are working together in this House to promote good legislation. We have been working on this bill this is our third year, and a lot of things we hear are parental consent. Why are we trying to take away the parents' rights? I have 5 children. Two of them are daughters. In their teenage years, they went to tanning beds. I don't think I ever signed a permission slip to do that. I don't think my wife did either. This is one of the things that we're really looking at. If I would have been knowledgeable and had what we're trying to put out today, any indication that melanoma, that possibility of causing melanoma in tender young skin as a parent, I would have never allowed it. But as teenagers can be and tend to be prom time, homecoming, and spring break, well, we got to get ready. We got to get that tan going. We got to look good. Well, that's all well and good, but when you look at the risk side of it, it's so much more important than the looking good when you're young. Another thing that we've heard in her testimony last year was that the tanning industry itself testified that the young 18 and under is just 10% of the business. I know I heard on the news later someone was upping that number now. I heard up to 50%, but in testimony from the organization itself, it was 10%. So to say that we're anti-business is not correct. We're not looking at destroying jobs, and that's what you want to hear. But human life and human misery and tragedy are whole influx of young people who are becoming susceptible to melanoma. This is a health issue. It's not a money issue, it's not a jobs issue, it's a health issue. We are very pleased today, and it's a big day for here at the Capitol, to have Karissa Martin with us, Miss Ohio 2008. Karissa, with her parents Ron and Stella Martin. Since being crowned Miss Ohio in June of 2008, Karissa has traveled across the state of Ohio, appearing in schools, events, meetings, pageants, sporting events, and parades and fundraising. She has been performing and speaking about Miss Ohio, Miss America programs, and skin cancer prevention for a second generation. It is with deep pleasure that I introduce her.
Thank you, Representative Combs, for the introduction. And thank you for having me. I've been looking for an opportunity like this to share my passion about skin cancer awareness, especially for our youth. At the age of 14, I had a precancerous mold removed from my scalp, and it resulted from one sunburn that I had when I was 5 years old. I was down at Royal Beach for the very first time, and that was my first experience of the beach, was getting a sunburn. It's the only sunburn I ever had in my life, and as I've gotten older, I've realized a lot of young people are not educated about the ways to protect their skin, and about the dangers of tanning beds, especially. The pressure that young women feel nowadays to look a certain way, is it more important to look good or feel good later? The rates of melanoma are on the rise, and they are more likely to occur when young women is between the ages of 20 and 30. I know personally several young women who attend the tanning bed numerous times. I know several young women who have had melanoma, many of them under the age of 25. I know families who have tanning beds in the home. Yesterday, I was speaking at an elementary school, and I had a second grader walk up to me and say, "Oh, yeah, I was in the tanning bed, you know, 5 or 6 times last summer." The girl was only in second grade, and you know, it makes you wonder how much education are we really getting about this. There are healthy ways to tan. Young people need to understand that, you know, use a spray tan, use a cream, use a lotion. Don't risk your health for just the moment of looking good for dance, looking good for spring break. There are ways to avoid the damage, but still look the way that you would like to look. It's not that we're saying that you can't look a certain way, you can't look the way you want to. It's just that we don't want you to risk your health. So that